Everyone, it's Brenda from Brenda's Knots and Loops. Today, I'm going to teach you how to make this crochet pattern by Lion Brand, the Beach Tote. They gave me permission to do this, so I will have a link below. So you can download the pattern to use also. It calls for this rewind yarn, tape yarn, I should say. It has 219 millimeters. It's a number 5 bulky. Calls for a 6.5 crochet hook, which we'll be using today. It's very soft and nice. Filling yarn, tape. The stitches is a double crochet cross stitch. Cross, where you cross, is the only really fancy stitch. This looks, I think we can do this. It's the first time I've really looked at the pattern, and so I'm going to do it with you for the first time, okay? So it says at the very beginning, chain 37. So let's do a slip knot onto our hook. Okay, make sure you don't get it real tight so it slides. So let's do 37 chains, which a chain you loop over, pull through, loop over, pull through. That's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37. Now it says single crochet into the second loop. So it's not, you don't count the loop that's on your hook. So it's 1, 2. Do a single crochet. Okay, we did that. And then do a single crochet across to the end. Alright, so let's do a single crochet in each chain. So far, so good. It's kind of neat to work with. It's not really, it's not hard to work with. I've never worked with this with a tape before. So this is kind of neat and new to me. If I'm going too fast, you can always pause, and if I'm going too slow, you can fast forward. I'm not gonna, I don't care either way. You do whatever you need to do for you. I'm trying not to go the first row is always the hardest when you do it in the chain. It's always the slowest and the hardest. You can't go real super fast. Oopsie. Boy, this is easy to work with. Easier than I thought it would be. And soft, very soft. Oopsie. Dropped that, didn't I? Okay, last one. Okay, now it says chain one and turn. Single crochet from two to row six, single crochet across. Okay, this is row two. I'm going to speed up my crocheting. You just pause if you have to. I'm going to just do this second row, then I'm going to pause the tape until I get to row six and I'll be back. But I'll do this row with you so you know. You single crochet into each single crochet all the way across. At the end, you chain one, turn, and do it again for a total of six rows. Okay. Oopsie. Make sure you get this last stitch. And make sure you get both loops. Okay, chain one, turn a work. Start again. Okay? Now continue and I'll be back on after row six. Okay, I'm back after doing six rows. Okay, we do chain one and turn. Alright, you guys ready for this row? This row is a little difficult, but we can do it. Okay, it says two single crochets in the first stitch, which is right here. So one, two single crochets, then single crochet to the last stitch. Okay, oops, crochet in each stitch just like we did before till the end. I'll pull up some more yarn. Oops. Almost there. Can't get over how soft this yarn is. To the end, and then okay, two single crochets in the last stitch, one, two. Place the stitch marker. Okay, let's get our stitch markers. You need to put a stitch marker in the chain two at the first that we did. Remember where we did two single crochets? Okay. Okay, it says place stitch marker in the first single crochet. Alright, we did that. Now, we need a stitch marker in the last single crochet. Okay, now turn your work sideways, work 4 single crochets down this side here. One, we're working down the side, okay, 3, 4 single crochets, get my tail out of the way there, 4 single crochets, evenly spaced, working along, okay, evenly spaced. Well, looks like I need one more. So, let me go back. So what I'm going to do is, instead of putting one here like I did before, I'm going to put one here. Okay, one. I need one here. So I'm going to skip one and put one. Then I'm going to put one, skip one in a hole. Then I'm going to put one right here at the very end. That's my 4. Okay? See what I did? Okay? Need 4 evenly, it said. So that's what I did. Okay, now it says chain 2. Okay, we put another marker in this corner. Turn your work. Sorry, I put the first single crochet on this corner. We put a marker. So we're on the bottom, okay? So we put a stitch marker on the bottom. I'm going through this the first time with you, so you gotta bear with me. Now, single crochet to the end. We should have 34 single crochets. Pull out some more yarn. Looks like we're going to have a stitch marker on every corner of our work. This is an interesting way to make a bag. Not the way I thought this bag would be made. Tell you the truth. Quite interesting. Oopsie. Just 1 minute. Let me fix my yarn. Okay, I'm back. Finished single crocheting to the end. Usually pulled my yarn through the middle, but for some reason I did it. The yarn in the middle was on the outside now, so I gotta fix it. Okay, make sure you get it at the end. Okay, now turn our work to 2 single crochets in the corner. Place a stitch marker. A different color, it says. Okay, use a blue one here. Stitch marker in that second single crochet. Turn our work. Now we're going to do 4 evenly down this side. So I'm going to do one right here. Let's get that. do one here. One here. One here. Okay. Do not join. Work in a continuous spiral. Make a marker the last single crochet indicated. Oh, okay. So my last stitch should have been here at the corner. So I gotta move that marker so I can get my stitch in there. Okay, replace my marker. Okay, row two, work two single crochets in the first stitch. One, two, then a single crochet to the marker, okay. And we are supposed to do the same thing to our 11th row. This is row two. The way to the end. Like I said, I didn't look at this pattern ahead of time, so I'm doing it first time. Sometimes the directions, the way people write them, aren't here at first, but you might have to read them a couple times so you can get with what they're trying to say, because everybody writes their patterns different, as you probably know if you read patterns. Okay, the last stitch is where our marker is, so in that stitch we do two single crochets. And move your marker to your last single crochet. Okay, now we're going down the side. Give me a minute, let me read this. Okay, I read it right the first time. We go down this side. And we move this, sorry, not the second one, but the first single crochet, sorry. Now we do four down the side. Two double crochets. You move your stitch marker to the first single crochet. Now we've got to put one more single crochet in that spot, in the corner. That makes a corner. It's two single crochets, makes a corner. Now, we single crochet all the way around to the next corner. Making sense now. Oopsie. The yarn's getting tangled. Yes, we're still on round two. We have a round, have a counter, might help, or you can do what I do. I just write it on a piece of paper, sometimes on the pattern, just depends. darn, oops. Okay, almost to this new stitch marker, so I can put the that, make two in the corner. I guess I should have done my two before I put my stitch marker there, huh? Down the side. Two in the corner. Get some more yarn here. Stitch marker in the first one. Okay. Why you do different colors is because that way you know which one is where you started. Okay? I know the green is my where I started because it's where my tie is. Okay? So let's go down this side. It's going to be a long video, I'm sorry, but that's okay. We're going to make this together. Learn how to read these directions together. It says we're making the body. Okay. Okay, we're almost to a stitch marker. Okay. Do two where the stitch marker was. Put our stitch marker back to the first single crochet we did. Single crochet down the side in each one. Okay, we're back to our stitch marker. Do two single crochets. Put our stitch marker in the first one. Turn our work. Now, just so we know, I'm going to show you what I do. In my inside my pattern, I'm going to be my I start with green. Green is my first, so I'm going to write down green so I know that's my where I start. I'm on row three right now, so I'm going to write down row three. So I know 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So I'm on three. Put a line through it, because I'm on three. Or you put a line through it when you get done. So, let's single crochet all the way around. Now, you can fast forward if you want, but I am going to stay for all seven rounds. Oops. Just so I know that you got this. All 11 rounds, I mean, I'm sorry. You can fast forward if you like. If I'm going too fast, you can always pause and fast forward. stitch. Please, I want to stay until puppy needs to go out. He's sleeping right now. So, oopsie. Okay, we're at stitch marker. Two, where the stitch marker was, two single crochets. Put our stitch marker back where our first single crochet was. Turn our work. Now we're going down the side. Crochet in each single crochet. Stitch marker. Whoopsie. Two. And the first one. Change our work. Put my yarn on this rounding thing before. See this rounding thing I got? And it spins around. Interesting. Never done it before. Okay. Yarn keeps on getting, or the tape keeps on getting caught. They pull it too fast, I guess. Single crochet in each. Like I said, I didn't read ahead on this pattern, so maybe I should have, but if I make mistakes, I want you to see, so I can show you how to, if you make the same mistake, how to correct it. That's why I'm doing this, or if you read the pattern along with me, so you can understand what they're saying. Like I said, sometimes you got to read it a couple times to understand what they're saying. And back to my first marker. Because remember I wrote down that my first marker is green. So I take out the marker, two single crochets in that marker. Okay, that was rule. This one, move my stitch marker. Okay, while I'm thinking about it, I'm going to show you in case you lose count. See, it's starting to curl, making a bag now. So what you can do is go in the middle. See where the middle is, this right here, our middle. See how it goes around like this. So put your finger on the middle. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? That way you know. Don't count all the way across. You can. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You know, divide that in half. So I'm on row 4. Okay? Put my stitch marker in the wrong place. So let's move it to the right place. Pull up some yarn. Single crochet again. All the be the, must be working on the bottom, because it's starting to curl. See how it's starting to curl up? Starting to make a bag. Oops. Don't want to do that. Pull, I guess. First stitch. A long ways to go, don't we? Yeah. We're on row 4. It's going pretty fast. I don't know if my mom creaking upstairs is picking up on the microphone or not. I don't know what she's doing, but doing something. She's always doing something. Okay, coming up on my stitch marker. Do 2 in that hole. I'm just going to do 1. 2. Remember, put the stitch marker in your first one. Let's turn. Well, pity sakes. Okay, do this one. Good first. Change our work. Now, since it's starting to curl inward, I flip mine, make it so I like to stitch on the outside instead of the inside of my of the bag or whatever. Because it makes it a lot easier to stitch on the outside than the inside. Basically, you're doing the exact same thing as you was. I just see, I was stitching in the inside like this. I just moved this to this side. So now I'm stitching on the outside of the bag. Makes it so much easier. Because sometimes that bag, the inside of the bag, can get a little tight. And this is a great thing if you're doing like pumpkins, baskets. If you just flip it a little bit, work on the outside instead of the inside, it makes it life a lot easier. If I'm going too fast with you, like I said before, you can always pause. Or you can fast forward till I'm at row 11. Come on, stitch marker. I'll at least drop that stitch. I must be excited about because I'm out of stitch marker. 2 where the stitch marker was. Put your stitch marker back where your first single crochet. Go down the side now. Oh, I'm green. So I'm on 5. Almost missed it. 2 in this hole. Move my stitch marker. Go down this side. See if the stitch markers look like they're in the wrong spot. But I'm doing it the way they tell me to, so we'll see. I want you to keep on doing what they tell you. Should turn out. A single crochet, but that's okay. We're changing it here in the next step, I think, because we haven't got to do our this special stitch, they said, which was crosses. Some people call them X's. Decorative on the side. Okay, stitch marker. I'll take it out. Do 2. Single crochets in the stitch marker. Stitch marker into the first single crochet. Okay, now we're down, going down our side. Stitch marker, 2 crochets and a stitch marker, first stitch marker, first one, give me a drink, sorry. Okay, now down the side. Crocheting. Our mouth is starting to flare. I can tell I'm having problems stitching. Pretty soon my speech will be. Alright, let me flip this. I'm starting to flip it the other way again. I want to stay on the outside. To the very beginning. 2 single crochets. Place our stitch marker. Come on, quit fighting with me. Okay. Mark. Number 6. Stitch marker. Two single crochets. Place the stitch marker. Now we'll go down the other side. This yarn's not this hard to work with. I'm going slow for this tutorial. Plus, like I said earlier, my fibromyalgia is flaring, so I have difficult crocheting, and it just started to flare up. I don't know why. I never know what makes it flare. Maybe because of training outside, I don't know. Sun shining and it's downpouring. But really, this yarn is very easy to crochet with, or tape, it's called. Forget what color this is. Is that Janella? I know Lion Brand had this to wear another stitch marker. Had another bag on their website made from this. It was two-tone, gorgeous. Think about making it. Okay. Let's get down the side. I see why they say different colors. So you know where you're at. At least different colors from where you start. But you can always tell by where your tail is. That's why I don't sew in my tail until the very end. Because I know that should be on my right hand side. That's where I started. Where the tail is. Oopsie, should have looked at the camera. Let's see if I was in a shot. Got a new stand. I like this stand so much better. So much better. It's cheaper than the other one I had. The other one was pain in the butt. It had flexible legs. Flexed all right. Camera wouldn't stay where it's supposed to be. Okay, I'm coming up to my first stitch marker. Remember I wrote down and remember it's green. Cool. scratch off another one. Go to 7. Sorry about that. Stitch marker. 1, 2. Sometimes you can stitch with the stitch marker there and sometimes you can't. Depend on how tight you make your stitches. I'm usually a tight crocheter. Which I'm trying not to be real tight this one. We're getting some slides here. I'm gonna get some yarn here. Like I said, I like stitching on the outside of the bag, but if you want, if you don't care or you don't mind, don't want to fight with it. Because the more rows we make, that it will eventually will stay the way I want it. But if you want to crochet in the middle, that's up to you. Whichever you're more comfortable doing. Just like how you hold your thread and how you hold your hook. Whatever's comfortable for you. You don't have to hold it the way I do. Not everybody does. This is the way I was taught. I've tried it other ways and I can't do it, but that's just me. Okay, we'll come up another stitch marker. Stomach brown. It must be past lunchtime. Hopefully you can't hear on camera. And down the side. Oopsie. What's the problem here? The yarn's tight is what the problem is. Lots of yarn. I'm trying to be in a hurry, but go slow. Does that make sense? I'm afraid you guys are getting bored with me. Or maybe you already fast forward. That's fine too. If you're still hanging in there with me, thank you. I've got 4 more rows to do. And we're on to something new. beginning. Okay, mark that out. Okay, we're on row 8. Stitch marker, 2, stitch marker in the first one, and then just turn our work, go down the other side. Oops, sorry. Stitch marker. Oops. Another stitch marker. Single crocheting. On 8 rows, 3 more to go. It's starting to curl nicely, making a nice cute bag. Try to make that stitch too tight, that's what I try to do. Just did not like it. remember, next week is be the 1st of August. I got 2 drawings. I got to draw for. Okay, we're 2 hours. Stitch marker at the beginning. Okay, before my camera died, we were on row 11. So let's continue with row 11. It's pull some yarn, get situated here. Okay, coming up on our stitch marker. I remove my stitch marker. Now, it's been a couple days, so do I remember? Just give me 1 second. We do two single crochets, and then we put our stitch marker back into the first single crochet. Now, we continue single crochets all the way around. How I got fuzzies, I don't know, but it's been a couple days since I've done the first video, but it'll be all right. Hope you just like if you set it down and start all over again. Like I said, I didn't read the pattern ahead of time. Some more yarn out. Oops. Like I said, I can't get over. Like I've said before, I can't get over how easy this tape is to crochet. It just fascinates me. This is the last row we do before we go to the next step. Oops. Said before in the video, if I'm going too fast, you can always pause and catch up, or if I'm going too slow, you can always speed up. Okay, another stitch marker. Do two. Oopsie, drop that stitch. One, two, stitch marker back. Single crochet and go back. Oops. Single crochet to the next stitch marker. Stitch to the stitch marker. Take the stitch marker out. Two single crochets where the stitch marker was in the same stitch. Put your stitch marker back into the first single crochet. Then continue single crochets into the next really handy that they said at the very beginning have different color stitch markers. That way you always know, like I wrote down, which one was the color I started with. So if you lay it down and come back later, you know. Plus I wrote down, if you can see over here on the slide, I wrote down how many rows, and then each row we did, I scratched off. So I know how many rows. Because I didn't want you can use a stitch, a crochet counter, stitch counter, if you want. You can download an app that's a stitch counter on your phone. But I wanted to show you, if you don't have or don't want to use, you can always, I write down on pencil because then I can erase it for the next time. Just continue single crochets. We're almost to the end here, or the beginning I should say. I got two more stitches until we get to the very beginning, and stop before you get. I'm going to remove my stitch marker, but I'm not going to do anything until we read what we do next. Okay, so single crochet, stitch around, and remove the three increase located markers. Okay, so we single crochet all the way around and remove your markers. So we do a single crochet all the way around. Just so we're, you know, we're on round 12, if you're reading your pattern with me. My stitch marker. Continue single crocheting. Said I've never done I've done quite a few bags in my day, but I've never done one quite this way. Close, but this one's a little different, but that's okay. I'll learn together. Okay, move it around. It's easier for me to see and do. Oops, almost messed up. Almost did a double crochet. We're doing singles. What happens when I'm not paying attention, I'm daydreaming. Single crochets. Lots of them. Oops. I try to pull my stitch too tight and it goes through. Alright, or to another stitch marker. So remove it. Stitch marker. Before I get it there. I'm going to remove it. It's on my way. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to put my Stitch Green one back over here in this corner so I know this is where I started. Okay? Just so I know, so I don't keep on going around and around and around, think I'm still on row 12. Just a reminder. Should have left it in to begin with, but I got back in there now. Whether I put it in the right place, I don't know. I'll check when I get there. In case you want to replace yours at the beginning, so we know where the beginning of the row is, I'll show you how we can tell where to put it back. Like I said, I should have left it, but I didn't. That's okay. Oopsie. Try that again. Oh, well, I did it again. Okay, I'm getting to the corner. So how you can tell, look for where there's two, see where they're right here, where there's two single crochets in one loop from the round before? That's how I know that's where we started, okay? Even though we did a single crochet in this round, the last round before, we did two single crochets in that one hole. That's how I know this is the beginning, okay? And that's how you can tell that's the beginning. Look for the previous row, the two single crochets in the same hole. And that's how you know that's where we started, okay? Before I get to my last stitch. Okay, next one. Single crochet in the round. Then it says, repeat row 13, which is a single crochet, all the way around until it measures 10 inches from the base. So, from the base. So, this is our base. The base is, can you see where it sets down kind of and starts curling up? See where it starts curling up? You can, when you curl it over, you can see where we started. So, from here up, which, let me count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rows, okay? 6 rows, we start measuring, okay? So, we want it to be 10 inches, all right? So single crochet all the way around. Don't have, and you don't really have to chain one or nothing. It is continuously go around and around and around until it measures 10 inches. Okay. So when it measures 10 inches, I'll be back. All right. So just continue doing single crochets all the way around. Don't need a stitch marker other than this. I would keep the stitch marker here, so you know this is where we begin, this is the beginning, okay? So you so, okay? So 11 inches, I mean 10 inches. When it measures 10 inches, you can come back, okay? So, I'll see you in a little bit. Okay, I'm back, and I have flattened out my tote here, and it measures 10 inches. So let's go to the next step, okay? Okay, now what we need to do is chain up three. One, two, three. Now I want you to double crochet in the chain, in the single crochet that's behind the chain three you just made. So this chain right here, the single crochet, is where I want you to do a double crochet. So you put your hook through the hole, go behind your three double crochet, your three chain three, grab some yarn, pull through the hole, and do pull through two, okay? And that will give you an X, all right? So let's do a regular X. Skip one, space, go into the next one, do a regular double crochet. Now, I want you to do a double crochet in the space that you miss. So you yarn over, go through the hole, go behind, grab some yarn, pull through the hole, and pull through two loops, and pull through two loops, and there's your X. Let's do that again. Skip a space, double crochet. Let's double crochet in the space that we skipped. Get some yarn. Okay, we skip a space, double crochet, and the next space. Okay, we double crochet in the space that we skipped. Okay, skip a space, double crochet in the next one. Okay, double crochet in the one we skipped. Yarn over, grab some yarn over. Go through two, go through two. Okay, skip one, double crochet. Okay, double crochet in the space that we skipped. Get some yarn. Okay, skip a space, double crochet in the space that we skipped. Yarn over, go through the hole, yarn over, go through two, skip a space. Double crochet. Now double crochet in the space we skipped. Skip a space. Make sure you not going through the space that you use already in. Make sure you skip a space. So skip a space and go in the space that we skipped. Skip a space, skip a space, double crochet in the space that we skipped. Okay, skip a space, double crochet in the next space. Okay, double crochet in the space that we skipped. Skip a space, double crochet in the next space, double crochet in the space that we skipped. Now see our X's that we're getting? Okay, let's go to the next one, let's skip one, double crochet in the space that we skipped. Skip a space, double crochet. Crochet in the space that we skipped. Okay, skip one. Okay. skip space, skip one. I'm going to speed up a little bit. If you need to pause, that's fine. But I think you know what we're doing. You can just double crochet in that space. And you double crochet back into the space that we skipped. Do the same thing all the way around. Skip a space. Okay, skip a space. Skip. Skip a space. Move my work around. Looks like I got some knotage there. Okay, I already did that one. Skip. Go in this one. Yarn's fighting with me for some reason tonight. Keep on putting my elbow on it. Makes it kind of hard. Skip. 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 One. Even I gotta check and make sure that I'm skipping the right one. I'm skipping. Sometimes it looks like you're skipping two spaces instead of just one, but you can make sure you don't go in the one I've already crocheted in. You're skipping one. Situated here. Skip one. Back on the back row stretch here. Skip one. Skip one. Oopsie. I'm supposed to drop one. I'm supposed to skip. I dropped a skip. Stitch. Skip one. Have these X's all the way around. Oopsie, sorry, I was out of shot. And that's some yarn, tape. Just double crocheting. OK. Okay, I was in that one skip. Oopsie. Can you see sick moving around so much? Trying very hard to stay in shot. My camera's, I don't know if I like this new stand or not. The end is where I wonder if I'm going to have the right amount of stitches. If we don't, I'm going to show you what to do. Anyway, I hope I don't, so I can show you. I'm going to show you anyway, no matter if I have the right amount of stitches or not. You can fudge it at the end. Because you want a frog or tear it out this stage of the game. Okay, skip one, which would be that one. Skip one. Skip one, which I am not really. This stitch has already been used when I did the last, but see, I got one stitch left. Well, we got to put an X there. So what you do, put your single crochet, your double crochet back into that stitch that already has the first double crochet in, okay? And then you go back to this one that we skipped, okay? Now I want you to slip stitch to the top of the chain three, okay? Now, I want you to make a single crochet back into that same stitch. And I want you to do a single crochet in each stitch, which I'm going to mark my first stitch, first single crochet, just so I know that that was my first single crochet. And I want you to do three rows of single crochet all the way around. You don't have to do a chain one or anything. You just do a continuous single crochet all the way around, and put one single crochet in each double crochet, okay? And do that for three rounds, okay? So one single crochet on top of each double crochet. You go around all the way around a total of three times. Continue doing that and I'll meet you back here, okay? Okay, I'm back after my three rows, single crochet rows on the top. Now what I want you to do is to lay your purse out flat. Let me zoom out. Oops, wrong way. Purse a little bit wider than, okay, spread it out flat. Now we're going to do the handles a little bit different than the way she did it. The way she did them is she wanted you to make the handles, the two handles separate, crochet it, and then sew them on. I'm not a real big fan of that. Why? Is because if you sew your handle in, when you put stuff in your bag, it'll pull. That's where it pulls. And that's where it can come unravel. And if your threads, tails, ends are, can come unravel and everything, and your handle falls off. So what I like to do is I like to crochet my handle inside my bag. And I'm going to show you how to do that. That way, the handle is attached already to the bag. You don't have to sew it in, and it cannot come unraveled and undone. There's no way. So it's more sturdy and can take more abuse. Okay, so what we're going to do is, she says she wants the handle 7 inches. Let me get it all flat here. 7 inches apart. 7 inches would be here and here, which that would give me 7 inches from the end. That's awful. To me, that's awful narrow. Your bag will, see how her bag sags on the corners? Which is fine if you would like it to do that. But I'm thinking about doing mine about 10. So what I want to do is fold your purse in half so you know where the middle is. Now I'm going to put a stitch marker on both sides where it's folded, so I know that's the middle. Okay, so if I do 10, that's still almost 6 inches from the end, so it's still going to sag some. So I want to put my 5 in the middle. So I want to put a stitch marker. I should move it up here, sorry. My stitch marker at the 10. And I'm going to go all the way through to the back side. I'm going to show why here in just a minute. I get some more stitch markers here. Okay. There's my 5. Now I'm going to do at my end. Now, what I want to do is get rid of this. What I want to do is count from where I have it folded to the end to this stitch marker. How many stitches? 1, 2, 3. I have 14. You could have something different. So I want to flip it up, then I want to count on this side. And that's 14 here. And 14. So now I want to count. That was my beginning, where I started. But that's not where this corner is. So you see where I started, and that's not where my corner is. So I want to count 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. That's where that stitch marker's at. Still this one in the middle, because I don't need it anymore. Now, I'm going to flip up. I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Here's my 14. okay. Okay? So, what I want you to do, because our beginning is not where our stitch markers are, so I want you to single crochet to our first stitch marker, okay? Wrong hook. That's awful little one. Just single crochet to our first hook. Now I'm to my first stitch marker. Now I'm going to count how many is between this stitch marker and this stitch marker. So I'm going to chain up 33. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33. Now, 33, just hold it, just, but I want it to be a handle. See, it's not very much, is it? Because it's straight. So what I do is that I usually double it. Or sometimes I just see how much. So let's just do 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now put your hook back where the next stitch hooker marker is. Now, is that as high as I want my handle? Or do you want your handle to be a little bit taller? So you decide. Make this your own. I think I'm going to add 5 more. You amazed how much just 5 stitches. I don't know. If I want 5 more, that looks, let's just do 5 more. So that's a total of 43 I have of chain. 43 is what I have. You make it as long as you want, but start with the width of what this is, then start adding. Okay, but 43 looks pretty good to me. So then what I want to do is then where your stitch marker is, the next stitch, do a single crochet. Now remember how many chains you have, because you got to do that again for the other handle. So a single crochet all the way to the next stitch marker. To just write down how many chains you did if you don't think you can remember. goes to the next marker. Okay, chain up however many you had. Yarn here. Okay, I got all my chain done. Single crochet in the next space by your stitch marker. Now we're going to single crochet all the way to the next stitch marker. Now I have the stitch marker, this one clear down here is where we first began. I'm going to not pay any attention to it. I want to go to my stitch marker for my handle. Doing your single crochets till you get to your stitch marker. I wish I would have brought a drink in this room with me. Getting kind of dry. Oh well, we're just about done. Some yarn. I think we're going to need two balls instead of three, like they said we need. All right, now I'm to my chain. So what I want you to do is do a single crochet in each chain. Okay, just single crochet. Might not be easy, but you can do it. Just hold it whatever way you have to. Put a single crochet in each chain for your handle. Okay? More yarn. Single crochet each chain all the way across. As many, you don't really need to count them. It doesn't make any difference. You gotta do them all anyway. So whether you have as many or more, depending if you wanted it to be, you know, really long handle or a really short handle. That is up to you. Whatever length you want your handle. That's why I wanted to do it this way, to teach you how to make handles what you want them to be, whether they're long or short. And like I said, when there's ones that you so on. I don't have luck with those. They always seem, because I've bought a lot of purses that the handles are sewn on, and they always come unsewed. Always. Always. Don't worry about it curling. You'll uncurl next round. To make sure I keep my hand, I don't know if you know this, I've always kept my hand on this row on the chain, so I know that it's not curling on me, because if it did curl, I'll just do the stitch, last stitch where it curled, where it's turned, will probably be in the back if it's curled on you. But you can make it look right. Like I said, this is very forgiving. This first, you don't have to be right on. Just make sure you get your last single crochet here. Now go back. Now go into, let me zoom in. Now see where we are? I want you to go into this stitch. We've already done it here. It's already attached. So I want you to go into the next single crochet with a single crochet, and that will attach your handle. Now I'll just do a single crochet all the way around to the next marker. And then we do the exact same thing. Turn my work here. Single crochet. Doing a single crochet and every single crochet to the next marker. Stitch marker. Sure you do single crochet right here. Okay, that sets you up. Do it in the chains. So we're doing a single crochet in each chain. Picked this bag. I thought it was pretty. That's why I picked it. I never looked at the instructions ahead of time before I asked the Lion Brand if I could do a video about it, how to make it. But it's not the easiest pattern I've ever read. It's written in a very different way. And she doesn't and the directions don't match the picture. And my hook keeps on grabbing down here. Oops. So I gotta hold it so you guys can see what I'm doing. My hook's too long. But with my arthritis hands, these longer hooks are easier for me to use. Done. Oopsie. Okay, make sure you do this last one. Now, open it up. Now see, it's already attached to this one, so we want to go to the next one. Do a single crochet. And once you do a single crochet all the way to the next, back to the neck, to the next handle. Next stitch marker. Go all the way around one more time so our handle is nice. Do you see? Just keep on going. Single crochet in the handle. Single crochet all the way around, all the way across this handle. Make this handle a little wider. Find out. Get some more yarn. That single crochet. Now when we get to the end, we're going to do something different, so don't Don't go ahead. I think we're going to go all the way around again, because we're not. I want to show you something. As soon as we get to the end here. Make sure you do it in this hook. Next, we already did this one and this one. Now, do single crochet in the next one. Now, I don't want this to be any thicker here. So, but like my handle needs to be wider. So I'm going to turn my work. And then I've already got it attached to the bag. So all I gotta do is go back, do single crochet back across the handle. Okay? Because I want my handle to be wider, but I don't want the sides, the side rim here, to be so wide. Don't worry, I'm going to show you how to get back across. If you wanted to, you could do this on the last row if you wanted to. That's whatever makes you happy. But I just wanted to show you that you don't have to go around and around and around and around. Your sides get so wide that it looks silly. Because I have seen patterns that the sides are really super wide and just doesn't look right. So this is my little trick that I have came up with. Yarn. I almost got my handle all the way across my handle. Here, so you can see into the last stitch. Okay, I want you to single crochet. We're at the next stitch, and then single crochet in the next. All right, turn your work. Now, to make this side match this side. Let me see. I want to make sure I need to attach it. I need to attach it to the. Sorry, I need one more single crochet on the side there, so it's attached to. Okay. Or, I'm sorry, it already was. See, I undone it. I undone it. Now, what I want you to do is a slip stitch. Sorry about that little goof there. Slip stitch all the way across. And then it'll sort of look like this, or you chained. But you also, if you want your handle to be even wider than this, you could continue to single crochet just like we was just doing until it's the size you want. And then, if you're on the wrong side of where you started, because we still have to go around to the other side, and this side we've already done single crochets to the handle, so you don't want to be lopsided. So that's why we're doing this single crochet, not only the slip stitch. Not only does it make it match, but it also gets us to the other side, because I don't want my handle to be any thicker than what it was, because I could have done a single crochet all the way across if I wanted it wider. But I particularly don't want mine to be wider, so that's why I'm doing a slip stitch. So have I totally confused you? So if you want your strap to be wider, you would have continued doing single crochets across here. But if you have it as wide as you like, just do a slip stitch. That simple, that easy. I try not to make it hard. Don't mean to make it sound hard. To the end here. Get to the last one, you slip stitch, and then you single crochet in the next stitch. Now let me move my work around here. Now we single crochet every stitch to our next handle. Hopefully I can explain it better in the second handle than I did in the first. I'll try. Okay, we're almost to the handle. We're over to the handle. So, single crochet in the handle. We're doing, I'm just continuing. I didn't stop. I just continue my single crochets all the way into the handle and curl it a little bit so I can okay, just continue single crocheting on our handle here. To the very end. backside, so do our slip stitch to get back to the other side. Okay, last stitch. Make sure that you anchor it to the last stitch. Should be fastened to your tote. So we turn around. And then we slip stitch all the way back. Gives your straps a nice finish. Plus it makes it look like the other side is close to. Bit. My slip stitch is really super tight, so that makes it look nicer. Okay, almost to the last stitch here. Okay, last stitch, I want you right there to single crochet. Single crochet. Now, you do a single crochet all the way to the next handle. Oopsie, hold on. My thread's underneath the camera. Sorry. Hope I didn't make you seasicker there. Don't ask me how I got under there. I don't know. Okay. Let me pull a little bit more yarn. Go right up to that last stitch. I want you to slip stitch it and then cut your yarn. Pull it through, and then all you have to do is sew it in. And there you go. Your bag's all done. Now you can remove your stitch markers. And enjoy your bag. And that's all there is to it. So thank you very much for being with me and making this bag, a tote, and learning how to maybe read a pattern too. This pattern was a little difficult to read, more than others. Unfortunately, her picture does not match her descriptions, but that's okay. We got through it just fine. We got us a cute bag. So thank you very much, and please like this video. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. And you guys all have a great day, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you. Bye-bye now.